Ningiukudluk, Tungasutsiavit Tamani, Nunavumi, Nunatsiavalumi, Haisimagavit.
Oh, Gave in this new role as president, you talked about the Harper government indicating, a distinct backward shift towards issues related to the Inuit and other Aboriginal peoples. What did you mean by that?
Well, there's a number of issues that we have been very heavily involved in for a long time, and those issues relate to environmental questions, climate change. They relate to the socio-economic health conditions of our communities, and also at the international level, the UN draft declaration on the rights of Indigenous peoples. Mm-hmm. Well, at the time that I gave my speech, the new government had decided that they weren't going to uphold the Kyoto Protocol. And we had worked on that for a very long time, mm-hmm. and we felt that this was not a good thing. Although now the government is saying they're coming out with a new plan, we haven't seen that yet, so we're not sure what's going to be entailed in that new plan.
Yeah.
As well, we had been involved in a process, a very extensive process, to address the gap between Canadians and Aboriginal people in terms of our lives and the issues that affect our lives. And we were in the process of working to close that within the 10-year period, close the gap.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a lot of commitments made by the previous government, and it was understood that they were prepared to support the principles
yes.
of the accord, but
yes. This is Kelowna we're talking
about. But they weren't prepared to
yeah.
implement
yeah.
as it had been, and then they voted against the UN declaration just prior to that meeting in Alaska. So, although I gave a very balanced report, that part of my speech got picked up.
Yes.
Because there are a lot of positive things also that have happened between our relationship with the federal government yeah. and Inuit, but these are some of the things that we yeah. have to deal with.
Okay, let's
Mary Simon, the President of the Inuit Tapirit Kanatami.
Prime Minister, Nakormek Inunit Kika Doksunga, Nakormekunga Ilinik, Mamiatsutit Ohagavit, Ilinia Tausimahatuit, Vinit Pichutigitsuit, Nakormek Maripogut Inuktitut. Mr. Prime Minister, First, I spoke in my Inuit language because I wanted to illustrate to you that our language and culture is still strong. Let us not be lulled into an impression that when the sun rises tomorrow morning, the pain and scars will miraculously be gone. They won't. But a new day has dawned, a new day heralded by a commitment to reconciliation and building a new relationship with Inuit, Métis, and First Nations. Let us now join forces with a common goal of working together to ensure that this apology opens the door to a new chapter in our lives as Aboriginal peoples and in our place in Canada. There is much hard work to be done. We need the help and support of all thoughtful Canadians and our governments to rebuild strong, healthy families and communities. This can only be achieved when dignity, confidence, and respect for traditional values and human rights once again become part of our daily lives and are mirrored in our relationship with governments and other Canadians. I stand here today ready to work with you, as Inuit have always done, to craft new solutions and new arrangements based on mutual respect and mutual responsibility. Thank you, and may wisdom and compassion guide our efforts. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Beautiful words.
Bonjour à tous. Merci d'être des nôtres. Let me begin by recognizing that we are on the traditional land of the Algonquin people. We acknowledge them as past, present, and future caretakers of this land. Canada is a place defined by people who serve those around them, who tackle big challenges with hope and determination, and above all, who never stop working to build a brighter tomorrow. In other words, people like Mary Simon. Frankly, we need more leaders like Ms. Simon in high office, people who understand what it means to take on real issues and create positive change. And that's exactly what brings us here today. This morning, I can announce that on my recommendation, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II has approved the appointment of Ms. Mary Simon as the 30th Governor General of Canada. Originaire du Nunavik, dans le nord du Québec, Madame Simon a passé sa vie à travailler au nom de ceux qui l'entourent. Au cours des dernières années, elle a été présidente du Comité national sur l'éducation des Inuits et, avant cela, présidente de l'Inuit Tapirit Kanatami. Tout au long de sa carrière, que ce soit dans la protection d'Inuit Nunangat, Arctique, comme défenseuse des droits et de la culture des Inuits, ou comme animatrice de radio avec CBC, Madame Simon a fait preuve de service dévoué. Je sais que Madame Simon donnera vie à sa vision d'un Canada plus fort pour tous lorsqu'elle occupera cette haute fonction. De ses années d'expérience aux nombreux honneurs qu'elle a reçus, Madame Simon lutte depuis longtemps pour un pays juste et équitable pour tous. Ms. Simon's career of leadership and service has always been one of breaking down barriers. She was the first Inuk to hold a position as a Canadian ambassador, representing Canada as both the ambassador of Circumpolar Affairs and as our ambassador to Denmark. Madame Simon a travaillé à la mise en œuvre de la première politique sur les revendications territoriales du Canada pour la baie James et le nord du Québec. And now we are honored to have Ms. Simon as Canada's first Indigenous Governor General. Canada is a big country. Canada is a diverse country. So it is only by reaching out to those around us, it is only by building bridges between people in the north and south, just like in the east and west, that we can truly move forward. Mary Simon has done that throughout her life. I know she will help continue paving that path ahead, and we will all be stronger for it. Today, after 154 years, our country takes a historic step. I cannot think of a better person to meet the moment. With that, it is a true honor to introduce Canada's Governor General Designate, Ms. Mary Simon.
Hey.
morning, everybody. Good morning, Prime Minister. First, I just want to say a few words in Inuktitut. So if anybody has a translator. So, Ullakuilunasi Ullumi Nakumiru Mayunga Kanada Angayoka Maringanik Dako House Riangit Ullumi Pimarium Mata Kanada Sibulipami Nunakasi Majumik Inumik Inutrinamik Dilijim Mata Tatsamunga Governor General of Canada, Dayo Yumut Inihagnea Matana, Nakomero de Yaratsuming, a Prime Minister. So I just, to say that in English, I would like to thank the Prime Minister for such a warm and thoughtful introduction and for this very historic opportunity. I would like to acknowledge today also that we are standing on the unceded territory of the Algonquin people who have lived on these lands and waters for thousands of years. Let me begin by conveying in the strongest possible terms that I am honored, humbled, and ready to be Canada's first Indigenous Governor General. I would also like to thank Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth for placing her trust and confidence in me to represent her in this wonderful country of ours. I can confidently say that my appointment is a historic and inspirational moment for Canada and an important step forward on the long path towards reconciliation. This is a moment that I hope all Canadians feel part of, because my appointment reflects our collective progress towards building a more inclusive, just, and equitable society. Inuktitut inalangam miga mamana kinaw mga ma hawyan maya ugaluaksung amisunu kisiyan ilangin na hawyan maya unginam amisun maganun Mary May Simon nguyunga Mary May me ate khatulok simayunga inuktitutunga ammalo inuktitut ate ga Ningiukudluk Quebec me ukiuktatu me nunahaktunga mana nunavimik teyausungulaktok ana anaga inulok simayok inutuinnausuni khallunati to khajagani ammalo atataga khallunangutsuni khallunannunganni pisimayok angajukhaga jau hatalok simajuk Hudson Bay Company kunun piroksasunga tamani nunavimmi simajunga taimangani ammalo inusaga inuktitut piusibunni atoksunga piroksimajunga. So permit me a moment to tell you a little bit about myself. I was born Mary Jeannie May. My Inuk name is Ningiukudluk in Arctic Quebec, now known as Nunavik. My mother was Inuk and my father was from the south, was manager of the local Hudson Bay Company post. I spent my adolescence in Nunavik, living a very traditional lifestyle. Many months out of the year, we camped and lived on the land, hunted, fished, and gathered food, and maintained an active connection with our Inuit heritage and language. Part of my cultural tradition as an Inuk are the strong bonds that are created across the generations. My grandmother, Jeannie, and my mother, Nancy, were my teachers and mentors, and these influences continue today. They both instilled in me a boundless energy for learning, self-improvement, and helping my community. They also taught me to always be proud of who I am and to keep my mind open to other points of view. From my father, I learned about the South and the non-native world from a man who had a profound love and respect for the North, its people, and its natural beauty. Combined with these experiences, allowed me to be a bridge between
the different lived realities that together make up the tapestry of Canada. I can relate to all people, no matter where they live, what they hope for, or what they need to overcome. As time passed, my work often took me south. I spent my adult life fighting for Indigenous and human rights, pushing for increased access for health care and access for mental health services, and working hard to build better educational outcomes for our children. So it's fair to say I've grown up twice, once in the north, northern Canada, and once in southern Canada. As Governor General, I am fully committed to setting and maintaining the highest possible standard of work and ethic in all aspects of my duties. Je prête au sérieux mon rôle de défenseur de la diversité culturelle et linguistique qui rend le Canada unique. I take very seriously my role as an ambassador for the cultural and linguistic diversity that makes Canada unique. I do want to be clear about something. My bilingualism is Inuktitut and English. However, based on my experience growing up in Quebec, I was denied the chance to learn French during my time in the federal government day schools. I am deeply committed to continuing my French language studies and plan to conduct the business of the Governor General in both of Canada's official languages, as well as Inuktitut, one of many Indigenous languages spoken across the country. Indeed, my appointment comes at an especially reflective and dynamic time in our shared history. During my time as Governor General, I will work every day towards promoting healing and wellness across Canadian society. Takani Pinasuwarinyaktakani, Governor General Ngulunga, Ulutamatia Pinasuhatolangabunga, Mami Saknek Pichutigilugu Ammalu, Inusatia Harni, Kanatamuliman, Ilunalimatia Tatamani, Kanatamiungata. To me, that means stopping to fully recognize, memorialize, and come to terms with the atrocities of our collective past that we are learning more about each day. It means we must thoughtfully work hard towards the promise of a better tomorrow. I believe we can build a hopeful future in a way that is respectful of what has happened in the past. It means supporting the well-being of people by focusing on our youth and improved educational outcomes for all of our children. It means prioritizing the protection of our natural world so that we can have a healthy climate and planet for generations to come. I believe strongly that if we embrace our common humanity and shared responsibility for one another, Canada's brightest days are yet to come. I am dedicated to doing everything in my power to build and inspire that future. And to all the women and girls out there, please know that we need more of your voices and perspectives in leadership positions across this country. I hope you use my appointment to believe with increased conviction that anything is possible. To the Canadian Armed Forces, I am honored to soon be taking on the role as your new Commander-in-Chief. I want to thank you for your tireless efforts in the fight against COVID-19 here in Canada and your operations being conducted worldwide. I am greatly looking forward to meeting the men and women of the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Canadian Rangers during my tenure. There is much to be done. We need and support of all of Canadians,
and our governments to rebuild strong, healthy families and communities. I would like to close by again thanking the Prime Minister for his commitment to reconciliation and the courage it took to appoint me to the position of Governor General. I can't wait to roll up my sleeves to embark on our work together, and may wisdom and compassion guide our efforts. Thank you. Merci. Nagurmik Huyennamik.
Mayolong ay mapaw ngalo, eksinakto mo ni ma.